Good morning to all of you. This is Murali here. We are in the chapter marginal costing. In the previous class, we have completed with problem number 6. Now we are moving to the next problem. That's the problem number 7. Kindly go through the problem number 7. This question is asked in the year 2014 for 12 marks. Omega Industries provide following information regarding smart light. The cost per unit is given, material, labor, and the variable overhead. Material rupees 50 per unit, labor rupees 80 per unit, variable overheads, that is 75% of the labor cost. Okay, what's given about the variable overhead? Variable overhead is 75% of the labor, that means 60 it is. Okay, then there is information regarding fixed overheads, rupees 2.4 lakhs, that means 2,40,000 per annum. The sales price of the Smart Light Limited is rupees 230 each. The selling price per unit, that is rupees 230 each. Okay, what we need to calculate? First one, there are three questions actually. Okay. For the each answer, 4 marks. Okay. How many units have to be sold in a year in order to break even? That's the first question number 1. The question number 2, how many units have to be sold to make a profit of rupees 1 lakh per year? That's what the desired profit is given. If there is a need to earn, if the company needs to earn 1 lakh profit, and how many units needs to be sold? The question number 3, if the selling price is reduced by rupees 15 each, okay, then how many units have to be sold to break even? Okay, break even, what's actually the break even? The break even means at the point at which the total sales of the company is equal to the total cost of producing the product. Okay, that's what the break even point. Now we are clear with the calculation of the break even point. So there are first question with regard to the calculation of the break even point. The next question is with regard to the calculation of the desired sales units, not the desired sales value. So we need to calculate the desired sales units in order to, if the company needs to earn a profit of rupees 1 lakh, so how many units needs to be sold? Then if the selling price is reduced by rupees 15, then in order to break even, how many units needs to be sold? Okay, so first question, I'm starting with solution. Kindly write solution. Solution. First question is with regard to break even point. So we need to write the formula of break even point. BEP, break even point. BEP sales units. BEP sales. We need to calculate the units. Break even point sales units equal to formula is total fixed cost. Total fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. Okay, this is what actually the formula. So kindly apply to the formula. Okay, what are the informations available? We need to apply that. Okay, so what is the information regarding fixed cost? What's the information regarding fixed cost? Fixed cost is given, that is rupees 2,40,000. Then what is actually mean by contribution? Contribution means sales minus variable cost. So write the fixed cost. Fixed cost is rupees 2,40,000. Then contribution means sales minus variable cost. Okay. Further simplify it. 2,40,000 divided by what's the sales? What's given about sales? Selling price is rupees 240. Minus variable cost. Okay, there are three informations regarding variable. One variable cost, one is material, then labor, then variable overheads, general variable overhead, 75% of the labor cost. Okay, right within the bracket, material plus labor plus variable overheads. Okay, Then simplify it. 2,40,000 divided by 230 minus, write the value of the material. Material is rupees 50, then labor 80, then plus what is given about the variable overheads? It's given variable overhead is 75% of the labor cost. So labor cost is 80, it's 75%, that is 60. Okay, simplify it further. 2,40,000 divided by 230 minus 50 plus 80, 75% of the 80 is 60. 75% of the 80 is 60. Simplified further, 240,000 divided by 230 minus 50 plus 80, 130, 130 plus 60, 190. Simplified further, 240,000, 230 minus 190, that is equal to 40. Therefore, BEP sales units equal to 240,000 divided by 40, that is equal to 6,000 units. Okay, so answer for first question is 6,000 units. Answer for the first question is 6,000 units. Okay. Now the second question, how many units have to be sold to make a profit of rupees 1 lakh per year? How many units needs to be sold to make a profit of rupees 1 lakh per year? Okay. That means the desired sales units. Okay. Write the formula of the desired sales units. Desired sales units equal to total contribution desired divided by contribution per unit. So if we can write directly, total contribution desired means desired fixed cost plus desired profit. Fixed cost plus desired profit divided by contribution per unit. Okay, apply to the formula. Fixed cost, what's the fixed cost? Fixed cost is rupees 240,000. Fixed cost remains same irrespective of change in the volume of the output. 240,000 plus desired profit. Desired profit is rupees 1 lakh. Desired profit is rupees 1 lakh. Divided by contribution per unit. Okay, variable cost per unit remains constant or same irrespective of change in volume of output. So contribution is already calculated. Contribution is already calculated. We need not calculate from the beginning. That is 40. That is 40. So we can write now 2 lakh 40 plus 1 lakh, that is 3 lakh 40,000 divided by 40. 2 lakh 40,000 plus 1 lakh, that is equal to 3 lakh 40. You can write and one more step you can write, and then you can calculate, or you can write directly 3 lakh 40 divided by 40, that is equal to 8,500. That is equal to 8,500 units. Okay. So answer for the question number 2 is 8,500 units. Answer for the question number 2 is 8,500 units. So two questions answered. Question A, question B. Okay. So now the question number C, third one. What's the question? If the selling price is reduced by rupees 15 each, how many units have to be sold to break even? Okay. If the selling price is reduced by rupees 15 each, okay, then how many units have to be sold to break even? So we need to calculate the break-even units only. There is a reduction in the selling price per unit by rupees 15. Actual selling price per unit is 230. It is reduced by rupees 15 means it is reduced to 215. 230 minus 15, that is equal to 215. Okay. Now write the formula of the break-even point. Break-even sales units. BEP sales units equal to fixed cost, total fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. Write the value of the fixed cost. Fixed cost is rupees 2,40,000. Fixed cost is rupees 2,40,000. Contribution per unit. Formula is sales minus variable cost. So we cannot write 40 now. Contribution, the first question, that was 40. Okay, 230 minus 190, that's why it was 40. And now there is a reduction in the value of the selling price by rupees 15. So we cannot consider 230 as a selling price here. We have to consider 215 as a selling price. So as a result, contribution changes. 2,40,000 divided by selling prices. So you can write within the bracket also. Okay, how it is? 230 minus 15, that is equal to 215. Okay, now the selling price is 215. 215 minus variable cost. Variable cost remains same irrespective of change in volume of output. So what is the total of the variable cost? Total of variable cost is 190. Total of variable cost is 190. Total of variable cost is 190. 240, 240,000. 215, 215 minus 190, that is equal to 25. That is equal to 25. So calculate now, 240,000 divided by 25, that is equal to 9,600. That is equal to 9,600. Therefore, break even units is 9,600 when the selling price is reduced by rupees 15 from to 32 to 15. Okay, there's a change in break-even units. So this is with regard to this problem. So this question is asked in the year 2012 for 2014 for 12 marks. Okay. Let us work out one more problem. Kindly see the problem. Problem number 8. Calculate break-even volume from the following information. Profit rupees 10,000 within a bracket is given 20% of sales. Then PV ratio, that is 50%. So with this information, we need to calculate the break-even volume, break-even sales. There is information regarding, there is only information regarding profit, that is rupees 10,000. Then PV ratio. Only two informations are given. The information is very less, but it is very technical and interesting. Okay. How we should calculate the break-even volume with these informations. Okay. So we have to try. Okay. If any mistakes happens at the time of solving the problem, then we need to strike out that. We should strike out that, and we have to solve from the beginning. Okay. So possible formulas we have to apply. So what is the formula that is used to calculate break-even volume? Okay, break-even volume. Break-even volume equal to break-even sales. Break-even sales value. Okay, or volume. We need to calculate the value here. Break-even sales value equal to fixed cost. Fixed cost divided by contribution into sales or selling price per unit. Fixed cost divided by contribution. When the variable cost is given for variable cost and selling price given for per unit, at that we have to apply fixed cost divided by contribution per unit into selling price per unit. Otherwise, fixed cost divided by contribution into sales. Because here we need to check now whether the fixed cost, we need to calculate break-even sales, whether the fixed cost is given in the problem. Fixed cost is not given. Okay, so we cannot apply that. Contribution is given, contribution is also not given. What is actually mean by contribution? Contribution means sales minus variable cost, that is equal to contribution, or else fixed cost plus profit, that is equal to contribution. But both the information, none of the information is available here. Into sales, what is the information? One information that we can calculate here with regard to sales, sales is given, it is given here, profit is 20% of sales. Profit is 20% of sales. So with these are the key points here. So we have to use this information. One is profit is 10,000, but that is 20% of sales. Then what is actually the sales? PV ratio is given. We should know the formula of the calculating PV ratio, contribution divided by sales. Okay. So let us calculate. It is a little bit interesting here. So what is given? Profit. Profit is given. Profit equal to 10,000 rupees. Profit equal to 10,000 rupees, that is 20% of sales. Profit equal to 10,000 rupees, that is 20% of sales. Therefore, sales equal to. Therefore, sales equal to. We need to gross up now. Okay. I hope you know how to gross up the values. Okay. Here the profit is given, that is 10,000, that is 20% of sales. Therefore, sales should be 10,000 into 100 by 20. Okay. Its actual value, that is 50,000. 10,000 into 100 by 20, that is equal to 50,000. Kindly calculate the 20% of 50,000, that is equal to 10,000. Therefore, sales here, that is rupees 50,000. So we have calculated the value of the sales. We have calculated the value of the sales. So we can apply this sales here. So we have calculated sale value. Then one more information is with regard to PV ratio. One more information with regard to PV ratio. What is given about the PV ratio? PV ratio is 50%. Okay. PV ratio that is equal to 50%. Okay. Kindly calculate one by one. Below that you have to write. Here wherever I am space is there I am writing. But in the notes you have to write one by one. Okay. Below the this calculation PV ratio equal to 50%. What is actually mean by PV ratio? PV ratio means contribution divided by sales. Okay. Contribution divided by sales into 100, that is equal to 50%. That is equal to 50%. That is given. Okay. Now we have to apply now. PV ratio is 50%. Whether the contribution is known to us, contribution is not known to us. Okay. So keep it as it is. Contribution, sales, sale value we know. What is actually the value of sales? Sale value is 50,000. Is it so? Sale value just now calculated with the help of the profit of 10,000. That is 20% of sales. So we have grossed up. That is rupees 50,000 now. Sale value is 50,000. So there is information regarding PV ratio. PV ratio value is given. PV ratio is 50%. So we know the formula of calculating. I told from the beginning itself. Don't remember it as a PV ratio. Remember that as a contribution to sales ratio. Then we can easily write the formula of PV ratio. So contribution divided by sales equal to PV ratio. Here the PV ratio is given, that is 50%. So 50% equal to contribution divided by sales. Sale value is 50,000. Kindly interchange the values now. 50,000 into 50%, that is equal to contribution. So 50% of the 50,000 is 25,000. Therefore contribution is equal to 25,000. Contribution is equal to 25,000. So we have calculated the contribution. We know the fixed cost, sales. Okay. Kindly use the marginal cost statement. Okay. Roughly we have to prepare marginal cost statement. We know how to prepare the marginal cost statement. So sales. What is the value of the sales here? Value of the sales is 50,000. Value of the sales is 50,000 less variable cost. Income statement or marginal cost statement. In the marginal costing, we are calling that statement as the marginal cost statement. In financial statement, we are calling that as the income statement. Okay, so both are right. Okay, sales minus variable cost. What is the variable cost? We don't know the variable cost, but we know what is actually the contribution. Contribution is 25,000. If the contribution needs to be 25,000, the difference of 25,000 should be the variable cost. Okay. If the contribution needs to be 25,000, the difference of 25,000 should be the variable cost, less fixed cost. We don't know what is actually the fixed cost here, but we know the profit here. Profit is given. Profit is 10,000. Kindly write that profit. Okay. Yeah. After deducting fixed cost, if the profit needs to be 10,000, difference of 15,000 should be the fixed cost. That's balancing figure. Balancing figure of 15,000 is a fixed cost. So now we can apply to the formula of the formula of calculating break-even sales. Formula is fixed cost divided by contribution into sales. Kindly write that one more time after preparing the marginal cost statement. The fixed cost is 15,000. The contribution is calculated. Contribution is 25,000. Into sales. Sales is 50,000. Therefore, break-even point sales value equal to 15,000 divided by 25,000 into 50,000. That is equal to 30,000. Okay. Therefore, break-even BEP sales value, that is equal to 30,000. Okay. So this is a way to calculate the break-even volume. Okay. Actually, there is only two information. Okay. This kind of question you may expect in the examination. Very interesting. I like this kind of questions actually. Okay. If all the informations are direct, then it is very easy to calculate. Okay. Here the informations are indirect. So this is a way to ask the questions. Okay. I usually ask the questions like this. Okay. So this is with regard to this problem. So thank you so much for watching the class. We will meet in the next class.